Chicka Wow Wow. You ready?
Yeah.
Well, look, I've got a new record coming out September 6th. And I'm so excited. It's coming up really soon. You can pre-order it right now, actually. A little shameless self-promotion there. But I was really excited to come play here tonight and play you guys some of the new songs off the record that you might not have heard yet. And this next one is one of those. And this is about, you know, when you get out of that, finally get out of that really shitty relationship with that shitty person. And then you find someone new and you're happy and you're doing great. And then they try and come crawling back just to see if they can still get their hooks in you. Well, I had that happen, and this guy gave me a big speech about how he messed up. I was like, duh, I'm awesome. And then he looks at me and he says, well, you know, he's talking about Mitchell, and he says, well, I just hope that you look at him the way you used to look at me. Bro, I don't look at him the way I look at you at all. And chilling too. So you know, I like to have a little bit of everything for somebody. Wait, something for everybody. I've had like 2 hours of sleep in my set. This is kind of like the breakup section of the show, and that was the fun sassy breakup song. This one's a little more serious, and one of my favorite songs still that I've ever put out. This goes out to anybody that ever had to be the bad guy. Thank you. guys sing that one. That's awesome. I do what I do so that I can relate to you guys and so I can put music out that makes you feel like I understand the life you're living. Because really, aside from me being on the road and doing this as my job, I'm the same girl I always was. My heart still breaks the same. I still drink beer the same. I still get hungover the same. And when that's the case, I got you covered. You have a few too many, maybe walking to work a little wobbly tomorrow. Don't drive if that's the case. Get an Uber. You just say, look at your boss and be like, hey man, country music made me do it. Some songs off the new record, and this next one is going to be on the record coming out. It's an EP called Wild As Me. Yes! You can pre-order it now. This song, you know, every time I go in to write or go into record and make a new album, I want to push myself further than the last. I want to dig deeper. I want to be more honest and more real, and you know, I don't want to make the same record twice. I want to keep evolving. And one part of my life that I've never really been open about in any way, let alone in my songs, is my faith. Because it came very late in my life. And when I started thinking about what God and Jesus meant to me, I felt very out of place because I didn't really grow up with that. And I started trying to pray and I felt kind of stupid, like, am I even doing this right? Am I saying the right words? can he hear me? Do I have to be in a church? And if I did go to church, like, what would I wear? And I had all these questions, and when I moved down to Nashville, I was lucky to meet some amazing friends who did grow up and could kind of answer those questions for me and help guide me to find out what faith meant to me. And that led me to write this song about that journey, and it's called Praying Right. I hope you guys like it. Advice and guidance. And what's that? Aww. Well, one of those, we got to give a shout out to the King. And you got to ask yourself, what would George Strait do?
Yeah.
on, boys. BC boy, Mr. Toby Duquette on the drums. Let's hear it. Right over here, another West Coast boy here. My favorite ginger, other than my mother. Sorry, Mom. Mr. Travis Twitchell on the bass. So, if you guys know me, especially if you follow my social media, then you probably know that I'm a woman that likes to speak my mind. I don't mince words, and I don't apologize for the way I feel, and I don't apologize for who I am, and neither should you. And I also don't apologize for the desires that I have that are very natural for a woman, that all women have. We got a lot of dudes on country radio singing about strip it down and t-shirt and wrecking ball and all that. And not a lot of girls, but you know what? Girls like sex too, because it's dope. So, as my friends like to call me, the queen of things I shouldn't say, I wrote this one for those girls and for all the girls out there and the guys who love them. The most attentive large crowd I've ever played for. It's awesome. So another kind of new thing for me this year and in this record is writing love songs. I mean, I've never done that before, and in fact my label's been asking me for for a few years, you know, we just really love a love song. We love a love song. I said, well, when I'm in love, I'll get you one. I only write about what I know, which up until recently was mostly drinking and making bad decisions and dating really bad dudes, so. But I found the person that can keep up with me and loves me, wild streak and all. And so I wrote this song for him and about us. And this is my current single. We're inching up on that top 10 right now. So if you guys are loving it, make sure you call into your local radio station, call into KX and tell them you want to hear it every day, all day. Party, Toronto? Damn.
Thank you.
What'd you guys think about Aaron Goodvin? Isn't he amazing? He is a label mate of mine and a good friend and a total badass. I'm glad you guys got to experience the awesomeness that is Aaron Goodvin. I'm kind of sad. This is the end of the set here, guys. And I want to thank you so much. I know this is staying up late on a school night. And I appreciate you guys being here. Not only being here, but being here and being so present and showing me so much love and singing along. It really, you guys will never understand what this means to me. It keeps me going when I'm on 2 hours of sleep. And earlier this year, you know, this dream has changed my life in so many ways, and I've given up a lot of things and I've sacrificed a lot of things, and I'm not complaining because this is the greatest job on earth, but it definitely doesn't come without sacrifice. And and you know, sometimes you think you've got the hit and you don't, and then sometimes you just write something that's just the honest to God truth, and it's real and it's gritty and it's not all that pretty. And sometimes country radio decides that they want to embrace the truth and the roots of where country music came from and what made me fall in love with it. And all that being said, after all the sacrifice, the most honest and gritty song I've ever written became my very first number one song. So thank you to you guys, thank you to country radio, thank you to my KX family here for supporting me since day one. And without further ado, let's party.